Hello everyone, I am Dr. Ipshita Ghosh, your faculty for endodontics. We'll have some direct discussion of some MCQs. First one is, persistent positive cultures from a root canal for long periods indicate, number one, improper drug therapy, number two, improper removal of necrosed pulp tissue, or over instrumentation of root canal, then poor coronal seal. Which one you will choose? So, for this improper drug therapy, there cannot be persistent positive culture. Second one, the improper removal of necrosed pulp tissue also, there cannot be positive cultures. Then C, number C point, in case of over instrumentation also, there cannot be positive cultures. Why? Even if there is over instrumentation, there cannot be microorganism left behind because the instrument may be sterile. So in that case, this option is also, we cannot choose. Then last one, poor coronal seal. Yes, this can be the answer. Why? Because if there is coronal seal is not proper, then there is chances of microorganism to get inside the root canal, and this may lead to persistent positive cultures from a root canal for long periods. Okay, so answer is poor coronal seal. Then the second question, most frequently observed organism in infected root canals are, I'll say this answer directly because there is nothing to explain. The environment of the root canal will allow the staphylococcus and streptococcus as the infected as the organism. So answer is directly, you have to remember number C, staphylococcus and streptococcus. Okay, number three, the percentage of gram positive flora in root canal is, answer is, options you will get 10 to 20%, 20 to 40%, then 50 to 60%, number D is 60 to 70%. Any guess from this? So the answer will be directly 60 to 75% of gram positive flora will be present in the root canal. So the percentage of gram positive flora in root canal is 60 to 70%. So this is the correct answer. Then the most common cause of pulpal inflammation, what is the answer? Number one, bacteria. Then option B is chemicals. Option C is iatrogenic problems. Option D is idiopathic disturbances. So I'll discuss from the point D, idiopathic disturbances. Sometimes it may not cause pulpal inflammation. Okay. Iatrogenic problem not always causes pulpal inflammation. Chemicals, yes, chemical also like this, because some chemicals are actually root canal disinfectant. So this option also we cannot take. What we can take? The answer is bacteria. Bacteria is the reason for pulpal inflammation. So the most common cause of pulpal inflammation is option A, bacteria. Then a root canal may be deemed bacteria free if option A, bacteriological cultures of the canals are negative. Number B, no exudate is evident. Then C point, no noxious odor is detected. Number D, all of the above are correct. Which one? C, it's not that if there is no odor, you cannot certainly say that there is no bacteria. Some bacteria are odorless. So option C we cannot take. So naturally the option D, all of the above are correct, we cannot take. So C and D, nikal gaya. Number B, no exudate is evident. This also we cannot take. If there is no exudate, then also there can be bacteria. So naturally what is the answer? Bacteriological cultures of the canals are negative. So a root canal may be deemed bacteria free if only the bacteriological cultures of the canals are negative. Okay. Then the another question, the frequency of transient bacteremia has been shown to be highest in patients with E. pylori fissure datum, multiple extraction, pulpotomy, root canal treatment. Here I have marked the answer. The answer is multiple extraction. Why? Because in case of multiple extraction only, there is more chances of infection, there is more chances of bacteremia. In case of pulpotomy, there is no chance, it's not always that there will be bacteremia present. Root canal treatment, option D, what we do? We is to remove the bacteria, we is to make the canal bacteria free, we is to make the canal sterile. So option D we cannot take, option C we cannot take. E. plus fish stratum also, there may not be presence of bacteria. So, only in case of multiple extraction, there can be transient bacteremia. Okay, it can also lead to this, due to this multiple extraction, this can also lead to cervical bacterial endocarditis. I have already mentioned this